Okay, so welcome back to our third example. In this example, we turn our attention to testing as opposed to confidence intervals. And we start again by doing the simplest possible case, namely we test for a single coefficient to be zero. So that should be straightforward. So let's see how we can do that. That topic, testing for individual components, is covered in section 5.3. And here, lemma 5.4 is what we need, and we just need to find what is t and what is h0. So we are testing the hypothesis a single coefficient beta I equals a given value. And for that, we need the test statistic, which depends on the estimate for beta I, so beta hat I, and on the value we are testing for. And that looks quite similar to what we did for confidence intervals, and the critical value is also the same one we just used for the confidence interval. So let's do that. For variety, I will use a different data set, and here you see stack loss data set, which is built into R, so it's quite convenient, and we have seen it before. So let's just recall how that's done. I think the coefficient one traditionally considers as the output is stack.loss, and the data set is called stack loss without the dot. And if we do summary M, then we see the picture we have seen before. So there are three variables plus an intercept, and we see here the estimated coefficients and everything we need. So for the sake of it, let's test whether the coefficient for water temperature is different from zero. So what do we need to do? We need to evaluate this test statistic, and then we do the quantile as before. And for that also we need n and p and alpha. Good, so x is the design matrix again. N is n row x, number of samples. P is n col x minus 1. And we really could know n minus p minus 1 is written here, so it's 17. But, well, this way we have done it ourselves. And then we need the estimated coefficient at beta I is qf m, and we want water temperature, so that's 1, 2, 3 in R's way of counting. Let's try that, hat beta I, water temperature 1.29, that's that value. And then we are testing for the value being equal to 0. Of course, the 0 will not do anything. And we need CII again, as before. I just copied that from up here. Only now we need row 3, column 3, and sigma hat squared. I can copy that from up here. Different model, but the formula is the same. And then we can evaluate t, so that's hat beta I minus b divided by square root of hat sigma squared times CII. That's it. So what do we get? T is 3.5, and the critical value, let's type that here, qt, then the level. Let's do 5% again, so it's again 0.975, and then n minus p minus 1 is 2.1. Then we just need to remember the direction. The test statistic is larger than the critical value, so we reject. Good, so that was easy enough, but of course, using the R output, it goes even easier, namely some of the numbers we computed already there. The test statistic 3.519, we could also have found here, rounded to 3 digits. And then that is what's called the p-value, that is the smallest significant level at which H0 is still rejected. And you see that is 0.002. So at 0.05, we would definitely reject it. And also see stars here indicate, here's two stars, that the p-value is between 0.01 and 0.001. So that means we would have rejected it even at the 1% level, but not at the 1 per mil level. And we are at the 5% level, so it is clear already from the presence of the two stars here, we would have rejected H0. Okay, and that's how we do a test for an individual regression coefficient in R.